So here we'll be covering the basic history of India, which includes your ancient history, medieval history, and modern history. So we'll have a gist of all those things, the events happened, how it basically framed the total India. Okay, so how today we have finally got independence, but how this base was started, and over a period of time, what were the events which led to the change in the particular history of India. Okay, so you'll understand all these things in detail. Before starting this, a small introduction about me, that I am your GK faculty, Nilima Gupta, and your current affairs faculty. So now, very first question to all of you, which particular temple or structure is this which you can see and where it is located? A very common, very famous structure. Okay, you must be seeing it every day as well, I'm telling you. Okay, so that is that famous. Yes, I want the answers. Somebody. Yes, Swami, very good. And where you can find this every day in your daily use? Yes, other students, who else know which structure or temple is this? And where you can find it every day? Sometimes this kind of questions are asked also, why I'm asking you every day. Yes. Okay, so only one student has given the answer. This is the structure of Hampi temple, which is located in Vijayanagar. Okay, so it was in a very important part of Vijayanagar empire. Okay, this temple is a monolithic temple made from one particular single rock. It has been cut and carved one single large size rock, and thus it is made. Okay, and this is inscribed on your 50 rupees note. Okay, so if you turn your 50 rupees note and see on the back side of 50 rupees note, the same Hampi temple has been inscribed. Okay, so you should be aware about all these basic things. So starting with the very first topic, just a second. Fine. The very first topic is Indus Valley Civilization. The timeline of IVC is 2500 BC to 1750 BC. Okay. So Indus Valley Civilization, if you can see here the image properly. Okay. So here we have the Indus Valley Civilization, India. So basically it was in the northwest section of the India on the Indus River. Hence it was called as Indus Valley Civilization, because majority of the civilizations which were found, it was located to the Indus River itself. Okay. So as you know, rivers are very important source of any civilization. If there is no water, there can be no civilization exist. Not only human, but even the animal civilization cannot exist anywhere. Okay, animal habitants also, sorry, not civilization, cannot be exist anywhere. So river is very important. Now these rivers are very important thing which I am telling you, kindly note it down. Okay. These rivers are not only important in history with relations to sites, but it's also important for your geography as well. In geography, it will play a major role for majority of the questions, and thus river gains an important part in your current affairs as well. If there is any projects, dams, okay, anything which is coming, the first question they ask you in current affairs based on which river. So all these things are important from your exam perspective. Starting with IVC, IVC was one of the earliest civilization, along with the civilization of China, which was based on Yellow River, then in Mesopotamia, which was based on Tigris and Euphrates, and in Egypt, which was based on the Nile River. Similarly, Indus Valley civilization based on the Indus River was an important civilization out of these four civilizations, which were basically existing in the whole world. Then comes your very first site to be ever discovered in the Indus Valley civilization was the Harappa civilization, and hence it is also called as Harappa civilization, being the first site to be discovered. It was discovered by Dayaram Sahani in 1921, and after that R.D. Banerjee discovered Mohenjo-daro in 1922, the very next year. And Sir John Marshall was the first ever scholar to use the term IVC. Okay, so this term was used by Sir John Marshall. The another important cities which are important from your exam perspective are the Lothal, Sutungaro, Alando, Balkat, and Kutsani. Out of this, now the most important city is Lothal. And one city has been missed over here. Okay, it was recently there in news, and hence it is important. Okay, that is Dholavira. Now tell me why Dholavira is important and why it was in news. Anyone who has been connected with the current affairs, side by side reading the current affairs. Answer me this question. Why was Dholavira is in news? Okay. And hence it became an important part for our exam from static GK as well. I hope out of you students, some of them for current affairs as well, if I'm not wrong. If you know, then say yes. If you don't know, then say no. At least we can move ahead. Okay, because if I'm getting no answer, I will have to wait. Okay, Swami does not have any idea. Fine. Okay, so students, very important part of current affairs as well. Note it down if you're writing it down in your notebook. Dholavira was recently declared as UNESCO World Heritage Site. One of the important privilege or the name given to Dholavira, the very first site from Indus Valley Civilization to be declared as UNESCO World Heritage Site. Along with Dholavira, the Ramappa Temple from Telangana was also been declared as the UNESCO World Heritage Site. So the sites to be chosen as a World Heritage Site is an itself hold a very great importance to that particular site. We will study about Dholavira and the features, what are worthy great things, why it is included in the World Heritage Site. Starting with archaeological findings of IVC. IVC, again, it's Indus Valley Civilization. I will be saying IVC, so be just understand with this term. Okay, so again and again, I won't say Indus Valley. Harappa Civilization, the major thing which was found in Harappa civilization were the six granaries in a row. Granaries are nothing but the big containers in which the grains are stored. Okay, and that too not at an individual level but at a city level, like how a government stores that in that manner. So six granaries in a row were found in Harappa. Along with that, virgin goddess seal stone symbols of lingam and yoni were also found. Then the dice painted pottery, clay figures of mother goddess were also found during that time. Then when we talk about Mohenjo-daro, the very great thing which was found in Mohenjo-daro was this great bath. Okay, this is the image of great bath. Here you can see two entrances. Okay, so the great bath itself had a very unique features. It had different inlet and outlet of water. Okay, outlet and inlet of water. Okay, so this had an hot and cold both water, and this was basically used for religious purpose. Okay, now also nowadays also, if you are a little bit connected with your culture or you know about the cultures, so you know there are many functions in which they basically you have to first go to that pond or something and then you have to perform your religious function. In that same manner, this great bath is used to also work. Okay, so first this was considered as a holy bath where people used to take bath and then go for their religious activity. Next we have the assembly hall which was there in Mohenjo-daro. Then the bronze image of nude woman dancer was also found. Pashupati Mahadev seal was found. This is the original seal. Okay, it's kind of broken in the original manner how it has been formed. Okay, then the steatite image of a bearded man which was found here you can see. So designed shawl was also given and one armed, and everything is right now broken down, but this is what we have found over there. Then we have found Chohandaro city. The unique feature of this city is this city is without citadel. Now what is citadel? Citadel is nothing but this is a city and this is an high lying area. Okay, at mountains, high lying areas, and this is a low lying area for common people. So this high lying area is called as citadel. Clear to everyone what is citadel? The high lying area on the mountains, okay, of a particular town is called as citadel. And the low-lying area is for common people. So Chohandaro was the only city without citadel. So there was a plain area in which even the king used to live and the common people also used to live. Then we have Dholavira. I told you very important site. Why? Because now it has been declared into the UNESCO World Heritage Site. The great thing about the Dholavira site was the water management. Water management was a great feature of Dholavira. And this was the only city to be divided into three parts. Now, one part is citadel, the other part is low-lying area, and then was one more part in which this city was divided. So, Out of all these unique features, this Dholavira is important and, as I told you, included in UNESCO site, making it the 40th site of India to be included in UNESCO. So, very important from your exam perspective. Then we are moving to important facts about IVC, that the main crops which are grown are, because this kind of question can be asked, it has been asked, okay, from Static GK. The main crops were the wheat and barley. Systematic town planning in grid manner. This was the town planning. Okay, so all the house used to cut each other at right angle. Okay, so this is house number 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is the manner how the house were there. If you have seen the animated cartoons like Doraemon, so there you must have basically found this kind of house. How many of you have seen that? It's quite easy for your understanding. That is why I'm asking you this question. Yes, how many of you have seen that? Because understanding the pictorial representation is very important from your exam perspective. Yes, Darshini Vidit, everyone has seen. Good enough. So there you must have seen how they have a house like this, a fenced house. Okay, then the another house comes cuts at a right angle. अगर अच्छे से उस कार्टून को ध्यान से, क्योंकि वो ज्यादातर टाउन के बारे में ही दिखाता है उनके. So that is important, and then there is a mountain. So that is a kind of town. You can imagine how Indus Valley was there. Now, why it is called a civilization? Because it was very well-developed civilization. House used to be cut at right angle. So much clear-cut marking and everything was made at that time. Okay. So not nowadays, like without any proper engineers or something that was made. There was in full systematic planning about everything. Then they used burned bricks, so they knew the technology 2,500 years ago that how to use the burned bricks. Then they had an underground drainage system that, like nowadays, everyone must have been seen at least in news. Okay, because of the drainage system, there is an overflow of everything, the waste waters and everything which is overflowing on the road. But this was not the scenario during the Indus Valley civilization time. They had an underground drainage system. So as I told you, this is a right angle. Just a second. This is a right angle. This is house 1, 2, 3, 4. Now its drainage system is connected with this line. Then this house drainage system is connected. Here it is connected. Here it is connected. And then it is going to a big drainage system. All the house drainage systems separately were connected to a big drainage system in an underground manner, well defined. Then fortified city, except Chuandaro, no temple was found. They used to be believed as a worshipper of the nature, earliest people to produce cotton ever in the world, and the origin of swastik, if you know this symbol. Okay, swastik, this was originated during the Indus Valley civilization. The reasons for the decline, what were the possibly reasons for the decline? The may real reason no one knows. Okay, but the possible reasons which can be there is drying up of Saraswati River, or because of the climate change. But the great reason, or the majoritily accepted reason, is a great flood would have struck the area. Okay, so there is a possibility that because of the flood, the whole area or the whole civilization got disrupted. Okay, this is possible because Mohenjo-Daro is said to be over flooded with the great tech, having the great technology, great drainage system. Then also the Mohenjo-Daro area was flooded almost 6 to 7 times, and though they survived all the times, but finally when a big flood came, they could not survive. So this is a general acceptance of the civilization. Next we have topic is Vedic age. Now as you can see the images, so you can understand what is Vedic age about. So the timeline of Vedic age starts from 1500 BC and 2000 BC. So this was a time of development of the various religious texts. Okay, various religious things were developing and getting its importance all over the world. Okay, so this was the same time when the compilation of Ramayana Mahabharata happened. Okay, so this was the time when the Vedas were developed, and this was the time of Gurukul system in India. Okay, so there were not like this today school college coaching, so it had a Gurukul system of learning. So this was a time when spiritual and religious things were developing to its heights. So the Veda word is basically derived from the root word, which means vidhi, which root word vidhi, which says the meaning is knowledge. So the four types of Vedas are developed, that is Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, and Athar Veda. All these four Veda has its own importance according to their Vedas. So out of this, the Rig Veda which we have is the Veda. Said to be said, not written by any human being. It is also called as Aparushya. Aparushi means it's been given by the gods to the rishis. Okay, so this is a text which no one has written. It contains a hymns of 1028 hymns, okay, which can be divided into 10 mandalas. These mandalas are nothing but you can consider them as books. 10 mandalas are nothing but the 10 books. Pay attention, important topic. Not every time you will get the clear conception of this IR topics. Okay. Yes. So out of this, the third mandala is very important. That is the third book, because this book only contains the Gayatri Mantra, okay, which is used every day in the by the people. Okay. So Gayatri Mantra, if I hope everyone must be aware about the Gayatri Mantra. Yes or no? Yes, fine, good enough. So the same Gayatri Mantra is been found in Rig Veda, third mandala, that is the third book. Now the 10th mandala again is important. Why? Because it contains the famous Purushukta theory. Purushukta theory holds a very, very great importance. If anyone is aware about Purushukta theory, what is this? So just say, tell me. If you're not aware, just tell no, you don't know. So I will explain you what is Purushukta theory. Okay, fine. When I will tell you, I hope all of you must be knowing. It's just because of the name you are not clear clarified. When I will tell you what is Purushukta theory, everyone must be knowing. Okay, so the Purushukta theory is nothing but the classification of the four types of caste. The classification of Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Shudra. This is called as Purushukta theory. Clear enough? I hope all of you must be aware about this thing. But this classification was made on the basis of the occupation. Later Vedic age turned this occupation into the caste. Okay, so this was made as an occupation, but later Vedic age turned it from occupation to caste. Next, we have the Samved, which basically deals with music, okay, and it contains various types of ragas like the famous Drupada raga. Yajurved is a Ved which is divided into two parts, that is black and white, Krishna Yajurved and Shukla Yajurved. Okay, so this contains the formulas and the rituals to deal with. And then we have the another important, that is Atharved, which deals with medicines and magics. Okay, so as I told you, Ramayana and Mahabharata was also developed at the same time. Ramayana was written by Maharishi Valmiki and Mahabharata was written by Ved Vyas ji. Next, we have Buddhism. Very important topic from your exam perspective, क्योंकि क्वेश्चन हर साल आते हैं बुद्धिज्म से एंड जैनिज्म से, और यहाँ पे कंफ्यूजन भी बहुत ज्यादा होता है. सो इफ यू पे अटेंशन, सो दिस कंफ्यूजन कैन बी इरेज, बट इफ यू मिस इट आउट, देन दिस कंफ्यूजन विल स्टे विथ यू. सो एवरीवन विथ फुल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, स्टार्टिंग विथ बुद्धिज्म एंड जैनिज्म. अंडरस्टैंड, गौतम बुद्धस ओरिजिनल नेम वाज सिद्धार्थ. ओके, गौतम बुद्धा वाज नॉट हिज ओरिजिनल नेम. हिज फादर नेम वाज सुदोधना एंड द मदर नेम वाज महामाया. महामाया वाज हर ओरिजिनल मदर हु डाइड आफ्टर गिविंग बर्थ टू गौतम बुद्धा, एंड लेटर ही वाज बोर्न एंड ब्रॉट अप बाय हर फॉस्टर मदर, दैट इज महाप्रजापति गौतमी, एंड फ्रॉम हियर ही गॉट दिस नेम एज गौतम. क्लियर? ओरिजिनल नेम इज सिद्धार्थ. He got the name Gautam from her foster mother, that is Mahaprajapati Gautami. The very great thing about the ancient India is, you will see here the name of the king is associated with the name of their mother. Okay, so basically ancient India में नाम जो भी होते थे child के, वो mother के नाम से associated होते थे. Now how we use our father name as our middle name? So basically it was the initial name was of our mother only. Then he was born in 563 BC at Kapalvastu, and then his wife name is important, Yashodhara. Son name was Rahul. Buddha's horse name is also important, Katha, because direct questions are asked. Charioteer name Channa. Okay, so at the age of 29, Gautam Buddha decided to leave his home, okay, in the search of knowledge, and the event in his life is called as Mahabhishma Karma. The name of this event is important because direct question is asked what. The renunciation of home by Gautam Buddha is called as what? Mahabhishma Karma, Nirvana, Dharam Chakra Parivartan. So direct question can be asked. The first teacher of Gautam Buddha is also important, that is Alrakalam. The another is Ramputra, Utkara Ramputra. At the age of 29, he left his home in the search of knowledge, and at the age of 35, he found his knowledge, full knowledge, enlightenment. And the moment he got enlightenment, that is full knowledge, is called as Nirvana. Okay, this Nirvana word is important because then in Jainism also you will find another word. So this is important, Nirvana. Next we have Buddha delivered his first lecture at Sarnath, and that is called as that event, that first lecture is called as Dharam Chakra Parivartan. Great events which happened is described with a symbol in Buddhism, and the symbols are asked in your examination as well. Okay, so the Janm of the Gautam Buddha was is represented with a symbol of lotus and bull. Then Mahabhishma Karma with a symbol of horse. Then Nirvana with a symbol of Bodhi tree. Dharmachakra Parivartan with a symbol of wheel. And then Mahaparinirvana with a symbol of stupa. Now moving with Jainism, here according to the Jaina tradition, there were 24 Tirthankaras, out of which the last was Vardhaman Mahavir. Okay. So we have basically studying about Vardhaman Mahavir only. Okay. So he was born in 540 BC, the same timeline of Gautam Buddha. Now, as I told you, Gautam Buddha's original name was Siddharth. Yes, you can see original name Siddharth. Here you will see Siddharth name as well. Okay. So this is the name of Vardhaman Mahavir's father. So be clear, otherwise you will get confused. Here, Gautam Buddha's wife name was Yashodhara. Here, his wife name is Yashodha. So just a very minute difference. So be very clear. So he renounced the age home at the age of 29. Just a second. At the age of 29 and got enlightenment at 35. Jainism renounced his home at the age of 30 and got enlightenment at the age of 42. So just a year, 2 year difference, and then there isn't a lot of difference because of this. So again, he delivers his first sermon, that is the lecture at Pava, to his 11 disciples. Then Jainism has the five Maharatnas, or the five woes of Jainism, very important. That is Ahimsa, non-injury, Satya, non-lying, Asatya, non-stealing, Aparigraha, non-possession, and Brahmachari, which was added by Mahavira Jain. Other four was already added by the other Tirthankaras, but the last Brahmachari was added by Mahavira Jain. Now this Jainism is divided into two sects, okay, two sectors, okay, between them, that is Digambar and Shvetambar. If you are a little bit aware or your Hindi is strong, then it will be very easy for you to classify. Siddharth name from Mahavira. No, with it, see, just a students, wait a second, let me clarify his doubt. Foster mother of Gautam Buddha name was Mahaprajapati Gautami. Okay, so Gautami name se bana Gautam, theek hai? Siddharth unka original naam, jab wo jaise ek koi baby paida hota hai to unka naam rakha jata hai, to original name unka Siddharth rakha gaya tha. Jab aage chal ke unko गौतमी पुत्र, ऐसे आप एंशिएंट इंडिया में बुलाते हैं गौतमी पुत्र, कुंती पुत्र, तो इसी तरह से गौतम बुद्धा को भी गौतमी पुत्र के नाम से गौतम गौतम बुलाने लगे. एंड देन बुद्धा वाज गिवन, द बुद्धा नेम वाज गिवन टू हिम व्हेन ही गॉट द होल एनलाइटमेंट. जब पूरी नॉलेज मिल गई उनको बोध गया ट्री के नीचे बैठ के, तब उनको बुद्धा नाम दिया गया था, और बाद में उनका नाम हो गया गौतम बुद्धा. तो दुनिया ने उनको गौतम बुद्धा के नाम से जाना, और ओरिजिनल नेम सिद्धार्थ उनका कहीं छुप के रह गया, और क्वेश्चंस ऐसे ही आते हैं. तो सिद्धार्थ नेम उनका ओरिजिनल था, बट वो महामाया से नहीं आया था, मतलब रख दिया होगा किसी ने, वो इतना श्योर नहीं है, लेकिन वो इम्पोर्टेंट भी नहीं होता, बस कैसे नाम मिला वो इम्पोर्टेंट है. Yes, I was telling, if you are aware about Hindi, ठीक है, आपकी हिंदी स्ट्रॉन्ग है, तो आपको ये सेक्स में डिविजन करने में, अंडरस्टैंडिंग में प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी. श्वेतांबर, श्वेत इज वाइट कलर इन हिंदी, ओके, व्हाइट कलर को हिंदी में श्वेत बोलते हैं, श्वेतांबर. सो दीज आर दोज पीपल हु वेयर व्हाइट कलर क्लोथ्स. आपने देखे होंगे ये ऐसे लोग रोड पे कभी आते जाते, कभी उनका ग्रुप जाता है, सो दे वेयर फुल व्हाइट ड्रेस, मेल फीमेल एवरी वन, एंड दे कवर देयर माउथ एंड एवरीथिंग. And then we have Digambars. So Digambars are those people who stay naked. Okay, so these are the two types of people in Jainism. Next, starting with Magad Empire, very important from your whole history perspective, not only ancient medieval, बट फ्रॉम होल, क्योंकि यहीं से मेन आपके हिस्ट्री की शुरुआत होगी. ठीक है, सो हिस्ट्री की जो शुरुआत होती है, ये जैसे पूरा इंडिया है, मान लो दिस इज योर होल इंडिया. ओके, सो दी मगध एम्पायर वॉज हियर इन नॉर्थ इंडिया बिटवीन यूपी बिहार. ओके, सो दिस वॉज अ डायनेस्टी जहां से ये डायनेस्टी स्ट्रांग हुई. और भी छोटे 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 जनपद थे, बट दिस वॉज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट, एंड दैट इज वाई दिस एम्पायर हैज अ लॉट ऑफ सक्सेशन वॉर एज वेल. स्टार्टिंग विथ हरनायक डायनेस्टी, इट वॉज बेसिकली फाउंडेड बाई बिम्बिसारा, द फर्स्ट बेसिक डायनेस्टी फॉर द मगध एम्पायर वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम. देन इट वॉज सक्सीडेड बाई अजातशत्रु हिज सन, एंड देन सो ऑन सो ऑन. लास्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट रूलर फ्रॉम हरनायक डायनेस्टी वॉज नागडस, हु वॉज डिथ्रोन बाई हिज ओन प्राइम मिनिस्टर, दैट वॉज शिशुनगा. एंड देन शिशुनगा फॉर्म्ड हिज ओन डायनेस्टी, दैट इज शिशुनगा डायनेस्टी after dethroning Nagadas. And then Shishunaga was succeeded by his son. And in the same manner, Shishunaga's prime minister, that is Mahapadmananda, dethroned Shishunaga dynasty and became the king and founded his own dynasty, that is the Nanda dynasty. So the same sequence has been followed in history. Then this is considered to be the first non-Kshatriya dynasty. पहली बार non-Kshatriya कोई as in king बना था. When you talk about Gautam Buddha और महावीर जैन, इवन बोथ ऑफ देम वर क्षत्रिय. ओके, फ्रॉम देयर कास्ट देवर क्षत्रिय, बट दिस वॉज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम अ नॉन क्षत्रिय टेकिंग अ ग्रेट इंपॉर्टेंस एट एन बिग लेवल. एंड दिस वॉज द टाइम ऑफ नंदा डायनेस्टी. नंदा डायनेस्टी के टाइम पे, एंड स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ धनानंद, देर वॉज एन अटैक ऑफ एलेक्सेंडर इन इंडिया. सो वील अंडरस्टैंड द इन्वेजन विच बेसिकली हैपन इन इंडिया ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम. The very first invasion which happened was the Iranian or the Persian invasion. Okay, in India by Doris I, which was around 200 years, led for 200 years. Introductions of new scripts were done, and this invasion was overthrown by Alexander. When Alexander invaded India, he overthrew this Irani people. Okay, then there was no Irani or Persian people staying here. They were only Alexander. Alexander basically born and brought up in Greece. Fight war from Greece and came up to India. When he reached India, he had a fight with a king called King Purushottam. Okay, the original name of the king was King Purushottam, but the Greek texts mention him as Porus. इसीलिए आप इनको एलेक्सेंडर और पोरस की लड़ाई के नाम से जानते हो, बट इनका ओरिजिनल नेम वॉज पुरुषोत्तम. एंड वेन दिस वॉर हैपेंड, बेसिकली क्या हुआ कि सब राजा जहां से ग्रीस से लड़ते लड़ते आते थे, सब एलेक्सेंडर के सामने झुक गए. सो किंग पुरुषोत्तम वॉज दी ओनली किंग हु डिड नॉट बो डाउन इन फ्रंट ऑफ एलेक्सेंडर. ही सेड आई एम रेडी टू डाई, बट आई विल नॉट बो डाउन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. दिस वॉज द रीजन दी किंग एलेक्सेंडर वॉज सो इम्प्रेस्ड बाई हिम. ही सेड प्रोबेबली दिस इज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैड अ वॉर एंड अ टॉक विद अ किंग इट सेल्फ. सो ही वॉज सो इम्प्रेस्ड विद द टॉक ऑफ किंग पुरुषोत्तम इवन आफ्टर द डिफीट ऑफ किंग पुरुषोत्तम. सो ही सेड ही बेसिकली गेव बैक द टेरिटरी ऑफ किंग पुरुषोत्तम टू हिम अगेन, एंड इवन दी टेरिटरीज ऑफ किंग अम्बी ऑफ तक्षशिला, एंड लेटर ही लेफ्ट इंडिया. ओके.